Hello guys, so this is the part 2 of nucleophilic aromatic substitution. In the last part we have seen one of the mechanism by which nucleophilic aromatic substitution reaction is possible. So today we will see another type of mechanism. Okay, so basically nucleophilic aromatic substitution, there are three main mechanistic pathways. Okay, so one of them we have already seen. Certain reactions classified as nucleophilic aromatic substitution appear to proceed through a different mechanism altogether. So the last day, the mechanism that we have seen, that is not the only mechanism. Okay, so the last day we have seen addition elimination, or there is another name you can use for it, which is SNAR mechanism. So today we will focus on the reverse step, that is elimination first, then addition, and this mechanism is also known as benzyne mechanism. Fine, and the third mechanism, there will be another video for that. Okay, so today our focus is elimination, addition, or benzyne mechanism. Now for this mechanism, first I will draw one reaction. So suppose we have chlorobenzene. We are using potassium amide, and in presence of liquid ammonia and very low temperature. So here we are getting aniline. Now see, this chloro substituted benzene ring, it is very weakly electron withdrawing group, very weak chloro, it is not nitrobenzene. So in the last mechanism, what we have seen, if there should be some electron withdrawing group present, and that should be very strong, then only aromatic ring, it can undergo SNAR mechanism. But now here we have taken chlorobenzene, which is weakly electron withdrawing, and we are doing this reaction at very low temperature. But in case of SNAR mechanism, we have seen that heat is required, right? So here we are not applying heat, but still we are getting some reaction, that is the CCl bond is broken, and now we are getting aniline in place of Cl. Okay, another reaction. See, here we have taken, here we have taken parachlorotoluene. So parachlorotoluene we have taken, the same reaction condition, only here it is potassium salt. And now we have taken sodium salt, that is the only difference. So here we are getting two different products. In the first case, that is when you have taken only chlorobenzene, you are getting just one product. But here you are getting two products. One is para substituted, another one is meta substituted. Okay. So here the position of chlorine with respect to CH3, it is 1,4. But our actual expectation should be that we should get only the first product, not this one, but actually we are also getting this. So what is actually going on here, that we can understand only by the mechanism. We have to go to the details. So here you can see what we have taken, the same molecule we have taken, right? Now in presence of NH2 minus, first this hydrogen, it is acidic because of the presence of chloro group. So obviously with respect to the other hydrogen in the aromatic ring, this hydrogen will be acidic. So that is why in presence of this NH2 minus amide ion, which is very strong base, and if you are thinking that why we have taken this strong base, because this hydrogen, it is attached to some sp2 carbon. So removal of this hydrogen, it is it requires some energy, so that's why we have taken strong base. So now there is a negative charge generation. Now this negative charge, if it is pushed here, then this CCl bond will be broken. Now see, you are getting a triple bond in the benzene ring. This is so unusual, right? But still, that is, we will also see how we can prove it, but right now just focus on it, that there is a triple bond in the aromatic ring. So this is the first step, that is the formation of this intermediate. This is the intermediate. Now here, the nucleophilic attack will take place. So our nucleophile here is NH2 minus. This is the nucleophile. Now it can attack either at this carbon or it can attack at two carbon. So one attack, two attack, both are possible now. So when it is one attack, now your negative charge, it is at two carbon. And when the attack is at on C2, now the positive charge, now the negative charge is at one carbon. This is one carbon. Okay. Now we are in the reaction medium, we have liquid ammonia. So liquid ammonia here, it is giving proton to this negative charge. And finally, there is protonation. So we are getting two different products. Okay. Now, if you are thinking that why ammonia is giving proton, that is so unusual. Normally, we know that ammonia is base, right? But see, this is all relative. Here, this negative charge, it is so basic that it can capture proton from NH3. Okay. So, relatively, this negative charge over sp2 carbon, it is compared to NH3, now it is more basic. So, that is why now this is acting as base and this ammonia is acting as acid. So it is giving proton. So finally we are getting two product. One is meta substituted, another one is para substituted. This is meta substituted, this is para substituted. Okay, so this is the mechanism. Now the next question is that which step is rate determining? Here you can see in the first step there is attack by amide. There is attack by amide and the first step is H plus removal. This is the first step. And the second step is cleavage of the CX bond. That is the second step. Here our X is Cl. So both of them, that is any of them can be rate determining. So how we will decide that? So when our leaving group is Br or I. So Br and I compared to fluorine and chlorine, it is less electronegative. So the ortho hydrogens, it will be less acidic. So that is why now H plus removal is rate determining step. Because now as it is less acidic, so removal of this H plus, it requires energy. Okay, if it is more acidic, obviously it requires less energy. That is why when the leaving group is A for Cl, now ortho hydrogens are more acidic compared to the previous situation. So now the cleavage of CX bond, that is it may be CF or it may be CCl, it is the rate determining step. Okay, so it may vary. Next, a new term. Now we will see which is sine substitution in benzene mechanism. So what is sine substitution? According to the definition, substitution at a site which is different from the one where already your leaving group is attached. If that is taking place, then the product that you are getting, that is sine substitution. Now if you go to the previous slide, obviously you can understand that you have started from para substituted product, right? So when Cl is substituted by NH2, that is the same position, this is normal product. But here NH2, it is not attached to that carbon where originally chlorine is present. So here this will be sine product. Now we will also see another example here. Here you can see we have taken 1,2 substituted aromatic ring. This is methyl group. In presence of NaNH2 and liquid ammonia, this hydrogen will be removed by the negative charge. You will get the triple bond here. Now the NH2 minus amide ion, it can attack at this position or this position. Now this is the sine product. Okay. Finally, there will be protonation. That is not written. That is final product will be this one. After protonation. So this is a sine product because your original leaving group, that is at ortho position with respect to methyl group, but here NH2 group is attached to at 3 position with respect to the methyl group. So that is why it is sine product. That is the left hand side, or I have here use different color, green color. But when it is blue color, that is the right hand side. Now NH2 is attacking at the ortho position, so your negative charge is at 3 position. So the final product after protonation, it will be the direct product. Okay, so that is so suppose any problem is given and it is asked that which product is sine product, which product is direct product. So now you can answer it. Fine. Now we have to know that why benzene, it is so highly reactive, and this is so unusual structure also, right? So this structure you have already seen. Now another way also you can write this structure, just if you break this bond, this is radical, okay? Or you can write it in this way, that is positive charge and negative charge, any of these, that is both the electron. Now here there are no electron, so any of this structure is fine. Now the question is what will be the hybridization of these two carbon? We know that rest of the carbon is sp2, all are sp2, right? But what about these two? Is it sp2 or sp? So suppose a normal double bond in, suppose just take the example of acetylene, what we know that it is sp, right? But here it is 180 degree, but 180 degree in benzene ring, that is impossible. It is 120 degree, so 180 degree we cannot have. So a linear acetylenic linkage cannot be formed in benzene intermediate because it is hexagonal. 180 degree we cannot have that arrangement. So this strange triple bond, it is formed by sidewise overlap of two sp2 orbitals. So these two are also sp2, actually all carbon are sp2, and this ring is still aromatic. Don't think it is not aromatic. Now I will write the electronic configuration of carbon, 2s2 2p2, fine, but one of the electron I am writing in 2p. So now it is like that. So if it is sp2 hybridization by taking 1s and 2p, so this is free from hybridization, okay? So there will be total 3sp2 and 1p per carbon. So if you focus on this carbon, it is using 1sp2 for bond formation with this carbon, it is using another sp2 for bond formation with another this carbon, okay? Now the p orbital, it will be involved in, that is not taking part in hybridization, that will be involved in pi bond formation, that is the pi bond of this aromatic sextet, okay? We know there is aromatic sextet here, pi electron cloud. But what about this? So this is another sp2. So 1sp2 it is using for bond formation with suppose this left hand side carbon, another sp2 suppose this right hand side carbon, this carbon, and the third sp2 is actually this. So it is same for the other carbon. Now see, this sp2 carbon, these are not exactly parallel to each other. These sp2 orbitals involved in the triple bond, they are at 90 degree to the p orbital of the aromatic pi system, that is aromatic sextet. If you think the plane of the aromatic sextet and the s, these two green orbital, that is the sp2, they are perpendicular to each other. So that is why, and this angle is 120 degree, so exact parallel they are not exactly parallel to each other. I'm talking about these two sp2, so obviously there will be poor overlap and the triple bond is very weak, so you can easily break it by nucleophile. Actually it is so reactive that we can never isolate this intermediate. It is very strained and reactive, okay? We can never isolate, but you can prove it. There are some evidence that we'll also see in the next slide how we can prove it, because we can't isolate it. So evidence behind benzene as intermediate. So here the first evidence is, suppose you have started from 14 carbon leveled chlorobenzene. So it is not simple chlorobenzene, because this carbon is 14 carbon, it is not normal 13 carbon. Isotopic leveled chlorobenzene we are using. Now in presence of NaNH2, any of these two hydrogen can be removed. Now you are getting this structure. So whether you are taking this hydrogen or this hydrogen, it doesn't matter. You will always get this benzene, right? Now the NH2 minus, it can attack at this position or this position. Now suppose if you have not done the isotopic leveling, so without this star mark, suppose there is no 14C, all are 13, then you will not be able to differentiate between these two. So that is why we have taken 14 carbon leveled chlorobenzene, so that we can differentiate these two. So you are getting both of these, and that proves that it is going through benzene intermediate. Otherwise, this kind of observation, it is not possible to get. Okay. The next evidence is bromodurin and 2-bromo-3-methyl anisole. So this molecule is bromodurin and 2-bromo-3-methyl anisole. So with respect to, that is anisole, that is with respect to OMe, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Now see, if this is your leaving group, both the ortho positions, it is blocked. There are no hydrogen. Here also, with respect to the leaving group, there are no hydrogen at these two positions. In both ortho positions, there is methyl group. So these two compounds, if you treat these two molecules under the, that is with the same condition, NNH2NH3 or KNH2NH3, you will not get any result. Okay, so it again, it is proving that it is going through benzene mechanism, because for benzene, to get a benzene intermediate, you require ortho hydrogen. Without ortho hydrogen, we cannot get benzene. Fine. The third evidence, strong electron withdrawing group next to halogen. So here, this is our halogen and strong electron withdrawing group CF3. This is the strong electron withdrawing group. So in presence of NaNH2, this is the one of, that is just one ortho hydrogen we have with respect to Cl. This is our ortho hydrogen. So if I write the mechanism, there is negative charge. Okay, now the nucleophile, it can attack only at, sorry, one step I have missed. So first the benzene intermediate will be formed. Okay, now NH2, it can attack at both position. So if it is attacking, suppose this is one attack, I'm just numbering arbitrarily. So from one, what you will get? Better I write double one, this ring. Negative charge will be here. Okay, and if it is two, then negative charge will be here, right? So which negative charge is more stabilized by CF3? Obviously the two attack, fine, because it is very electron withdrawing group CF3. So this species you will not get, you will get only the second one. So finally there will be protonation. Okay, and this is our NH2. Sorry, I missed the NH2. Okay, so here we are getting only the meta product. So again, it is the evidence that you are getting single product when there is a strong electron withdrawing group next to the halogen. You are getting single product. It is the evidence that it is going through benzene mechanism, because this is our logic why we are getting just one product. And the last evidence, which is very interesting, suppose you are doing the same, any reaction that may go through benzene mechanism, suppose same reaction you are doing, but what is the difference? You have added anthracene to the reaction mixture. Now this is our anthracene molecule. So in the medium, If benzene is formed, then it will act as dienophile. We know in Diels order reaction, we require diene and dienophile. So this is our dienophile. Dienophile means any species which is looking for diene. Phile means affection or love. Okay. So this is our dienophile. So if you are getting this type of product in the that is in the reaction mixture along with your original that is substitution product, if you are also getting this, so this type of adduct, this is actually adduct, then it is again proving that benzene intermediate it is present in the reaction medium, otherwise we cannot get this type of Diels order adduct. Fine. Okay. Now this is the last slide. Here we will see different types of benzene generation. Don't think that benzene generation it is possible only in presence of KNH2 or NaNH2 and liquid ammonia. This is the only condition for benzene. No, that is not the case. There are different other ways by which you can generate benzene, and I have mentioned there some of them. That is also not, that is, these four are not the only condition. There are some other examples also. So I have taken some important example here. Br and F, they are at 1 and 2 position. So in presence of Mg and actually this is dry tetrahydrofuran. Okay, so this is a condition of basically Grignard reagent preparation. This type of condition we use. So here Br, it will be converted to MgBr. Fine. So finally this CmgBr, it bond will be broken and this CF bond will be broken and you are getting this benzene. Okay. Now come to the second one. For this type of molecule also, when you are just simply heating, you have not added anything, you are simply heating, again you are getting A, because I have already named here A, the same molecule. And this portion will be removed as nitrogen and this portion will be removed as sulfur dioxide. Okay. Now what are the third and fourth? In the third one you can see there is fluorobenzene. We are treating it with PHLI, phenyl lithium. So there will be lithiation of this hydrogen. Don't think that any of this hydrogen you can lithiate, only this hydrogen which is just at ortho position with respect to fluorine. So this is activated. So this you can write it in this way. So this pH minus, it will take it and this position it will be, there will be lithium. So okay, so here the another side product is PHH, which is simply nothing but benzene. So here also CF bond and CLI bond, it will be removed. So you are again getting A plus LIF. Okay. So this is the third. And the fourth one, see NH2 and COOH. Okay. This is known as anthralidinic acid. In presence of nitrous acid, we know that we cannot generate nitrous acid directly. So you have to use NaNA2 and any acid mixture. Okay, so if you use this mixture, HNO2 will be produced in the reaction medium. NH2, it will be converted to N2+. During diazonium coupling, this type of condition we have seen how to use and how to generate N2+, that we have seen. So, N2 is very good living group. That is a nitrogen, dinitrogen gaseous molecule. And if you write the COOH in this form, then this OH bond, it will make, it will be broken and the driving force is actually CO2 liberation, decarboxylation. There will be a double bond. This bond will be broken and you will get a triple bond here. That is again you are getting A, and nitrogen and CO2. These two are a neutral and gaseous molecule. So it is liberated. That is the driving force of this molecule. It can easily move towards the forward side because we are getting two neutral gaseous molecule. Okay, so these are four ways by which you can generate benzene. There are some other examples also. These are not just limited to these four. Okay, So if you find the video helpful, please like, share and subscribe. For the other related videos, you will find the link in the description box. I will meet you in the next video. Until then, goodbye and thank you for your time.